AddSub and Overlay are two special, very useful blending modes. They can darken and brighten at the same time, depending on the values of the top component. All other blending modes so far can only darken or only brighten. They're not the easiest to use, but are essential modes to understand. Both AddSub and Overlay have a special behavior that depends on the values of the top component. If the top component is brighter than 0.5 middle gray, they will brighten the bottom component in your result. If the top is darker than 0.5, it will darken your result. And if the top is at exactly 0.5 middle gray, the bottom is left unchanged. AddSub's name already tells you that it's a combination of add and subtract blend modes. Dark values at the top will do harsh subtractions, light values will do strong additions. AddSub requires some understanding to use and requires some care in low dynamic range. Because the values of the top determine the behavior, AddSub is non-commutative, so swapping top with bottom looks completely different. For masks, AddSub has the unique ability to only affect transitions, something not many blend modes do. In those cases where you have a mask that needs grunge and detail in the transitions from black to white, AddSub is a perfect match. Just keep in mind, your top mask needs to have those blurry transitions and your bottom grunge has a good range of detail and values. AddSub is also useful in other, less obvious cases when combining grunge maps. Just remember to try to swap the order for a different variation. With Heightmaps, AddSub requires a lot more care as it performs two harsh operations at the same time, pushing both in and out. Standard, contrasted maps will hit low dynamic range limits all the time, so you will have to adjust your top values very carefully. Often, it's easier to split it up and use a separate add and subtract operation for more control. Overlay is AddSub's softer, smoother cousin. It's a combination of multiply and screen. Screen will give you smoother, fading bright areas, where multiply creates smooth, dark areas. Just like AddSub, the order of your top and bottom component matters, making Overlay non-commutative. Overlay is a great blend mode to add quick variation to a mask. Because it uses multiply and screen, it's not as harsh as AddSub, so you can use it as a single step to add both darker and brighter areas to a base mask. Overlay is at its best when you keep those neutral, middle grays in mind. If your top or bottom is too bright or too dark, Overlay might not have much effect. Overlay can also work on transition gradients, but the effect is much softer than AddSub, making it less useful for these cases. For height maps, Overlay's soft nature comes in handy, as it causes no low dynamic range problems. It is perfect for combining two height maps that are well balanced, where your bottom is your main shape, and the top component provides smaller detail. Your main shapes will be transformed, with the details pushing both up and down. Here's a recap of that. AddSub for masks is great in transitions, replacing soft gradients with harsh details. AddSub extrudes height maps both in and out, but easily hits limits with harsh results. Overlay is good for smoothly making your mask brighter and darker in a single step. And Overlay transforms your base height maps with balanced details, distorting it in two directions.